In this demo, we're going to take a look at the following features: Data Controller, Comments for Address and Communication Data, Shareholder Relationships and Company Interest, Tax Categories for Supplier, Permitted Payee, Return Supplier Flag, Incoterms Location IDs, and Acceptance at Origin. In S4HANA 2023 for Business Partner, we'll use a supplier as an example. On the general level of the supplier, we'll see the assigned data controller, and then we'll take a look at how to maintain comments for address and communication data, and we'll see how to add a shareholder relationship. Then we'll move to the supplier level, where we will check and maintain tax categories and permitted payees. Then on the purchase organization level, we will see the return supplier flag, Incoterms location IDs, and acceptance at origin. First, we start with an existing supplier and create a change request. The supplier SwissTech is based in Basel. I choose the supplier and then edit. I select the change request type, process supplier, and enter the description. We see that there are already two data controllers assigned. I have the authorization for the first one on the list, SAP_DE, so I can change the supplier. Scrolling down to the addresses UIBB, we see the comments and the address. I can choose the pencil icon to change the details for this address and to see the comments in multiple languages. Scrolling down to the communication UIBB, we can see the column for comments in the telephone numbers, mobile numbers, fax numbers, and emails. Here I can quickly add a new mobile number and comment, for example. And also in the international versions UIBB, I can see and add comments in multiple languages. You may have also noticed another new feature. This content button has been introduced to allow you to collapse and expand all of the UIBBs on the address detail page. Navigating back to the main page, we scroll down to the shareholder relationships. Using the new button, I can create a relationship using relationship category is shareholder of and the company with partner ID 501, which is SwissTech Payment Company. They have a 100% share of SwissTech, and so we also set the control flag. On the supplier level, we can see the tax categories. Here, we already have two tax categories assigned. I can also maintain the alternative permitted payees. I can search for the SwissTech Payment Company supplier here and choose this supplier as an alternative permitted payee. Now on the purchase organization level, when I use the collapse button, I can see that I'm in purchasing organization 0001. In the purchasing organization control data UIBB, I can set the return supplier flag for my supplier. Next, I can maintain Incoterm location IDs. You can maintain Incoterms on the purchasing organization level, or you can maintain it on different purchasing data. On the purchasing organization level, under the purchasing organization conditions UIBB, we see Incoterms location ID 1 and 2. You can also maintain Incoterm location IDs in the different purchasing data UIBB on the subrange level. Here, I choose subrange 0001 and I can maintain Incoterms version. I choose Incoterms free house and the location IDs 1 and 2. I can also set the origin acceptance flag. Then I click on Done and go back to the main page. I have finished making my changes and I can submit my change request. Thanks for watching.